Let's do this. Blizzard, not a bad start. Man, you know how good Babbling Book is? It's rated higher than Blizzard in our tier list. I don't like the RNG, though. I generally pick all the RNG cards, except Bombers, a little lower than we put them. So I'm going to take a Blizzard. But that's just how good Babbling Book is. Blowgill Sniper or a Noiltron? I'm actually going to take an Noiltron. With a Blizzard? Like, we have a theme going on here, you know? Adi's Valet, it's a legit 2-drop. So, the way you draft Mage is you want a curve, and the curve should be, like, a actual curve, and then you want big cards. So, Frostwolf, not the way to go. Boulderfist Ogre is a big card. Stormwind Knight doesn't really help your curve. Stormwind Champ is a little too good, and we already have 2 2-drops, so it's not like we need 2-drops, and we're going big, we might as well get a Stormwind Champ, right? Friendly Bartender is good too. It's actually really good for Mage. But we have 2 2-drops already. I'm not going to take another 2 this early. Dollar and Aspirant is not too solid of a drop. Fencreeper Taunts, I'd rather have Fencreeper. Because you still have to Hero Power to build up that spell damage. Mad Bomber, yes. Fretted with... I spared you guys that one. Fretted with Golden Fire says, "That Grinning Go, I'm confused. I thought the tier list was what you thought players who wanted your win rate should pick. So if you're playing Blizzard of a book turn one, shouldn't it be rated higher?" Right now, there's a couple of like hand-adjusted ones, but it's the difference between me and Merps also. So there's 2 things going on with the tier list. One is it's mathematical, based on certain like assumptions about RNGs and things like that. So it penalizes RNG to a certain extent, but I penalize it more. And two, some things Merps moves around also, and I don't agree with it. So the tier list is our tier list. We would each make somewhat different decisions with the tier list. So no one will ever tell you to follow a tier list, even on pick one, like right down the line. Especially for something like 2 points. You'll see how well it works out. Also, what's not accounted for in the tier list is the position in which the cards are picked. So, some cards get a lot better if you can pick them really early because of synergies, and Blizzard's one of them. It's a deck archetype and synergy builder, so picking it on as the very first pick gets actually significantly more value than what the tier list would say. Like, if you know how to draft with a Blizzard in mind, which is not that hard. Who are you people that are voting, and why do you want a Mech Warper? Now I'm confused. Cookie Chemist is way better. Like, way better. We already have 3 2-drops. What do you guys want? Why are we having so many random trolls? Even the 2/4 that draws a card is better. I'll take a Bluegill. We're going to be off the board. Bomb Squad over Injured Blade Master. We need a curve. And Bomb Squad does hurt us, which we can't really afford to do. But it is just like also a lot better than Injured Blade Master. This one's actually close though, between Bomb Squad and Injured Blade Master. We need 2-drops. Tempo Mage is the best. No, I mean, Tempo Mage is not the best. Having a curve and then having enough value is the best way to play Mage. So, to the extent that you consider having a curve tempo, then yes, tempo is good. But you don't just blindly pick a whole bunch of twos. I'm gonna go a little... Like, here's the problem, right? We also don't have removals. I'm gonna take a Bomb Squad. I hope we'll get enough threes. I can understand an Injured Blade Master. I think these two are so similar right now in value for this deck. Dragon and Crusher, yes. There we go. Like, look at this. I rate Spellslinger as, like, completely awful. It's below average. It's a 3/4, and I rate it below average. Why? Because of the RNG. I'll take the Nerubian Prophet. That's half a 3-drop. right? Like, it's sometimes a 3-drop. This is total crap. We have a Medivh's Valet, and we're getting a bit big. So I'm actually going to take a Mirror Entity here. It also opens up the doors for other, like, secret picks. No Arcanosmith, Novice Engineer, we need the value. No Shatter, Friendly Bartender. See, we're getting our twos. Like, this deck has just gotten its twos from not even trying. Like, I'm not even going to pick a Biofantide. I kind of need to pick a Biofantide Hunter. Yeah, you know what? I agree with you, Chad. I'll take an Agent of Blossoms over a Biofantide Hunter. 1, 2, 3, 4. We already have 4 twos. We're fine. Miss Lackey could have been a Secret Mage. You don't want to play Lackey with a Mirror Entity. What do you want, a 2-drop? I'm tempted to pick a freaking War Golem, but no, we do still need some twos. Friendly Bartender is a good two. War Golem is stupidly slow. We don't have any threes and fours. Okay. These are fours. That's a five I don't need, but it's a card. Potion of Polymorph is not really a card. No, guys, I'm not taking a Potion of Polymorph. Second Ray Bruiser could be played with less mana. So we're in danger now. Now I'm regretting not taking the threes at least. Right, we have 2 fours, we have 1 3. We need more threes. I would normally take a Master Jouster, but for the chance that this comes out for three, I think it's worth it. Oh good, Argent Horse Rider. That's a three. Zubat's a 3. Cone of Cold is a card that can go into a Blizzard. We have no Flame Strikes. We have nothing we're really Cone of Colding into. It's a Zubat. Oh my god, we're actually going to have a Cabal Lackey in this deck. We're going to have a Voodoo Doctor and a Cabal Lackey. Cabal Chemist or Direwolf Alpha? I would normally take a Direwolf Alpha, but this is not a Direwolf Alpha deck. I'm going to take a Cabal Chemist here. We need more value. Like, there's actually not enough value in this deck. Like, we have 3 truly big cards. And that's it. And we have 2 1-drops. Oh, good. Because we need size. Yeah, we have enough twos. We're gonna take 1 more 3 afterwards. And we're gonna try to take fours, but it's not made up for by more twos. It's gonna ruin me. So we were offered like no twos, and the 1-3 we passed up on was too much. This is a really, really bad mage deck. It is way too slow. We're gonna take a Sunwalker over a Cabal Courier. Cause we need to just defend. Okay. So our problem is now that we have too many 5-drops. Way too many 5-drops. It was between a Bomb Squad and a 3-drop, and I would have taken the 3-drop, but keep in mind, we still have no removal. Like, this deck has more problems than just its mana curve, which did not work out. Right? This deck also never had any removals. There's no small removal. There's no large removal. There's no Flamestrike. There's no Firelance Portal. There's no Polymorph. There's no Fireball. There's no, Frostbolt, Flame Cannon. Like, all the mage stuff, we didn't get any of it. In fact, I don't even know how many mage cards we have here. Like, this is a very, very bad deck.
Jaina,
we have 4 5-drops.
You asked for it.
Oh, sorry, did I say 3 6-drops? I meant 4 6-drops. 1, 3, 3, 4. Good enough for my curve.
Behold the Legion
things I command.
One day, I'll be a real knight.
Then I Ardra Horse Rider has one drop. Plays a three, I play an Aruvian. Nope. No need.
Dragno, stupid!
I'm gonna lose the board. There's no way around it. No matter what I do, I lose the board. No matter what I had done, I lose the board.
Don't worry, boss. The cavalry's here.
Get in! Don't run away!
He can't ping here. He wouldn't be able to use his mana, so he's gonna eat it. Never mind, he does ping. Good for him. Okay, I do have the board. I was all scared I wasn't gonna have the board, but.
You call that?
There it is. We're fighting for the board.
Delicious spider ichor. Shiny.
Aww.
Have another dose. It hurts. Wanna blow something up?
And we play the slow things down game. He's happy to play this game with me, apparently. No wonder he's happy to play this game with me. It's fine, though. Stormwalker's good unless you can get rid of it. Which is good, because I'm about to die. Hopefully I'll be able to get the Sekhmet Bruiser out for cheap, because he plays something, pings the 4-5, and doesn't trade in. Nope, that's a fireball. Or a bomb squad. Three. I get three bluegill and ping. Get Fen Creeper and bluegill.
I wonder.
That does a little more. I get bomb squad and bluegill. I think I'm dead if I do that. I'm just gonna die.
Time runs out on me.
It's boom o'clock!
I'm watching you!
Like, we're at the point where I can't be afraid of things like that. Like, if he was gonna kill me, then I was gonna die. Bartender, that's pretty nice.
I'm not ready to take your time.
Oh, no, he found his fireball. You know, these cards I wish I had. Yeah. This is a really bad deck. You know what? I'm almost certainly going to finish this deck today, so I'm going to start the bet right here. Feel free to bet whatever. It's starting at 01. Feel free to bet anything you want. I can't tell you what this deck is going to do, because there's no way to respond. It's a deck that doesn't quite curve out and has no ability to play off the curve, off the board.
Jaina versus Valera.
What?
It is a very, very bad deck.
You asked for it.
See, like, this isn't even good. I'm gonna do it, but, like, I just spent two cards. He's gonna remove with a coin hero power. And I'm not gonna have a two drop. And I'm not gonna have enough cards. So, the tempo barely accounts for the fact that he's gonna, like, I'm gonna get no value out of this thing. I hope he can give me like a beast or a dragon or a what's the other one? Murloc. Okay, you know what? This is not bad actually. He's not playing anything small. So maybe he doesn't have anything small and I'll just get something big as like a default one. Triggers. Wouldn't that be nice?
It's good to see you again.
Face Wolf, HS. Welcome to the Grinning Goat, 9 months. Thanks for feeding the goat.
We're having a goat baby, and it's a perfectly normal sentence. Nice. Oh man, people with actual goats. I'm so jealous. The nice thing about Chemist was how it didn't die. Yeah, but we get more value out of the Chemist, you know? Like, we don't need the Chemist now. We can get more value out of the Chemist later. I'm okay with letting him dagger down something.
Locked and loaded.
This is our town, scrub.
Yeah, beat it.
I'm not ready.
Okay. Why not Shadow Strike the other one? Because he wants to take extra face damage? Oh, okay, Shuriken.
Delicious spider ichor.
My mother does love this face.
Oh, hey, he just quits. Wonderful.
Well played.
I like people who assume that I have good cards just because I'm Mage. Mage has the worst cards now. Because it's the- well, Mage and Rogue. They have the most uneven, like, card distributions from, like, good to bad decks. They just rely on their hero power. What I love about Rogue, and that's why, like, almost all Rogue runs go really well for me now, is I've just totally, like, given up on the whole idea of taking two drops.
Jaina versus Gul'dan.
Because that dagger is so good.
Your soul shall be mine.
You go first. I'll keep a bluegill. It's a playable card. I don't ask for much right now with these curves. I just need playable cards. Tiger Radley says, that guy ruined what was definitely an 0-3 deck. I don't comment. This is one of the worst mage decks I've ever seen. I like to think that you get 5 wins with every deck. I like to think that. This deck challenges it.
Small in size, huge in evil.
When you discard a card, gain +1/+1. Right. It has the chance to grow. He does nothing. That's interesting. So he's gonna play a 3-drop. Which Minor Ruby and Prophet can almost certainly eat. And the Zubat could also trade with if you Kooky Chemist.
Hmm.
Let's be on the board. There's very few things he could play right here for 3 mana that I can't eat with the Kooky Chemist. That would be one of them. I mean, still more intimidating than a croc. Oh. I'm just reading this now. Apparently the goat baby was a joke. About 9 months. And a human baby. Not an actual goat baby. How long does it take a goat to have a baby? And, okay. I think I can do this. I don't know when I'm gonna get this value. Oh no, you know what? I can get the value from the tiger.
What to do?
It's probably better value I can get getting from the tiger. Because, like, the friendly bartender isn't doing anything. It adds up to basically the same amount of it.
It only cost my soul.
Cool. Alright, that was a little upsetting. Won't lie. Like, the problem against Warlock is you can't just build up a board. Because that's how you lose. Because he has Abyssal. You need to get some damage on him while building up a board. This is like tightrope you have to walk.
I smell blood.
Okay. That's cool. He kills that. He kills the beast. It's too much, man. Oh, or I could Kooky Chemist this and get 13 damage right now. Ooh, that's dirty.
Delicious spider ichor.
I don't even care if that's the right move. That's the move I'm going with. He may get me off my board, but I'm just gonna play a big thing and ping his face every turn. I have no reach in this entire deck. That was an awful move. It does mean he can't play, like, all Abyssal Destroyers are dead in his hand now, which is nice. Yep, use a removal, double trade into the other one, and we begin the slow dance of can I stall long enough to ping you to death, and can you heal often enough that I can't do that? Good thing about Warlocks is they don't have big heals. All their heals are, like, tiny. What? Is he really gonna hurt himself? He should not hurt himself. Oh god, that's all he can do? What the hell? I'm gonna taunt him. When he was drafting, he forgot to tip his sword. Alright, we're 2-1. Making the most out of this deck. Horse Rider. That's true. Horse Rider is reach. We have up to 2 damage of reach in this deck after the Tiger.
Jaina versus Gul'dan.
Your soul shall be mine.
You asked for it.
Mad Bomber for a lucky 3. And then it's like stuff that we can get from Ethereal Conjurer and stuff like that. Alright, Cabal Lackey. I will say this, he's showing up on turn one a lot, which is the only good thing. Miss. Dealing 3 damage to me so I could deal 2 damage to his face. I think that's worth it.
Clobbering time.
So, chemist or spider? Random potion or discovering a beast? I guess potions are more useful. I have my plays afterwards.
Drink the power.
Great. I take that back when I said potions are more useful. I guess I could always play this on turn 6.
It's boom o'clock.
My face is in danger. My face is in a lot of danger.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
Wait.
Oh God, my face. Why so much autocorrect?
Truth is my shield.
I have no way to get rid of this.
Job's done.
Okay, that's good game. I mean, yeah. That guy showed like no good cards except like one Siphon Soul. But I had to ping on turn 3. And once you ping on turn 3, without any initiative in your hand, it's kind of over.
You asked for it. Oh, it is on.
Cool. This deck survives on taunts, which is a very risky way to survive. Perk System says, come on, Adwicta, I bet 3. Hey, man, why didn't you bet 5? Believe in me, Perk. 3 is the most heavily betted on one. Although we did start at 0-1. So maybe 3 is the correct bet. I do want this to go to 11 at least. So I think 5 wins is good for going to 11. Yes! Worth it. Totally worth it. Oh, so worth it. This is a good way to get some value out of the cookie chemist. If he plays like a Gurubashi or something.
What to do?
Wanted. Dead or alive.
Alright, that doesn't really do anything. Just tiger.
Could have actually just gone face, waited for him to do something and then Blizzard, but he clearly has no small things. So I'm never playing this Blizzard. This Blizzard is gonna be like a freeze and go kind of move. Is this the turn I sense demons? Because if my mana's awkward enough, I might sense demons the next turn with the Cabal Chemist. Just so then, afterwards, I can start throwing 1/1s on the board when I have more mana to use.
Shall we put a kink in your plans?
Oh, that's interesting. Also problematic. Because he has a good flame strike if I do it. I guess I don't really have a choice.
What to
he has
do?
A large removal, what which he could very do? Well have. He has a very good one if I just ping.
Drink the power.
Go for it. You wanted a flame strike? I gave you a flame strike. Well, that's not even a flame strike. That's just a lame flame cannon.
Talk about a nice suit!
I didn't even do that flame cannon right. Flip it. Kill it. Guessing he has no flame strike.
Delicious spider.
Well played.
Okay. He wants to ping the 1/1. Yes, it's greedy. But he's at the point where he kind of has to be greedy. I agree with his play. This with a ping gives me 3 mana. I have nothing to do with it. I trust that he has no flame strikes. So.
Meesh, man. For Blackwing!
Well played.
If he has a flame strike, he gets to clear my whole board, and we're even. But I know he has no flame strike in his hand. So
drink the power.
He has a top deck hit. That's cool. Shatter!
It hurts! Join or die!
Blizzard and go time. It is officially Blizzard and go time. He got. So I'm accumulating a pretty good card advantage lead at this point.
I hear you got a problem.
Nope.
Time left for cover!
Nope.
Well played.
Tilt the imp.
Well played. You win.
All right, two more wins, and we get this to 5, and I feel happy about the run. Because this is like an epically bad deck. Which is fair, because we've had some pretty good decks. The mage deck we started with this season is insanely good. Then the next Jane Warlock was Jane. Odd, but still kind of above average,
you
maybe. The one after that was below average, even though it went pretty well. Or at best average. And then the rogue deck was above average. Very much above average, that rogue deck. Keep the mirror. So, we were kind of due for a bad deck. So exactly how many people bet 5?
Excuse me, you are on fire.
Very few, actually. Everyone bet 3. Only 6 people bet 5.
Don't forget to tip your card.
No one believes me.
For the crusade!
Coin out a kooky chemist. Which will guarantee that I'll be able to play the second rate bruiser the next turn.
Delicious spider ichor.
Because a 4-5 with a taunt is pretty good for 4 mana, so. Six with a ping and a voodoo doctor.
Have another dose! It
good for an Angel of Blossoms, huh? Pretty good. No? Okay, that's fine. That's getting all sad. But, I'm Mad Bomber. I don't think I'm Mad Bomber. I choose Hero Power.
It's Boom O'Clock!
He has no way to deal with this. Oh, never mind. He does have a way to deal with this. Hit my face. Thank you.
For the king.
All right. Not as much thanks as I was hoping.
Shields up.
Okay. That's weird. I'm gonna charge him. And then I have 5 mana.
What to do? What to do?
So I could bomber before I charge, and if it hits that, I can ping and then charge the other one. Or I can charge mirror. No. This is the best
one. Wanna blow something up?
Uh-huh.
make things easy.
Don't worry, Lux. The cavalry's here.
Giddy up!
So he's probably saving something big, right? Because he just played a bunch of small stuff. That's the way I'm thinking about it. Or if the other card in his hand is a spell, he doesn't really get a choice. He has to play, like, the card in context. No matter what it is.
Do you call that
a weapon? Alright, fine.
Do you call that a weapon?
Sometimes you don't like your life very much.
Excuse me, you are on fire. Excuse me, you are on fire. Truth is my shield.
Good.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
Right away.
Shush.
Good. I'm out top decking him right now. And most of my cards, small cards, are done. We actually have a lot of big cards, so. I feel pretty confident about my top deck skills. Saving this effort for when I need it.
No. I need to get my Ethereal Conjurer or things like that. Oh, God. Alright, well, whatever. This is why I kept the Emperor Cobra back.
I hope you like my invention.
Delicious spider!
I don't have enough mana.
I have something to take care of big things and something to take care of small things. Cool. Now I get a potion myself.
Drink the power.
Good as a volcanic potion.
Have another dose!
Cash that in. Get some face damage on him.
Trogzor!
Good, good, good.
You want it?
That's what I want.
I got it.
And yes, I might as well use it. Yay! I save plus one attack on the board and dealt two phase damage with that card.
An autocrat? I suppose.
Well played.
So, four wins, huh? Getting close to five? Is the trust in Adukta's ability to play this game getting slightly restored? Just grinding it out with these guys. Because whatever the deck is built, it still has more big things than most decks at this rank, right? Like, if you took an average deck at, like, 3-2, this deck is bigger.
Versus Gul'dan!
Your soul shall be mine!
You asked for it.
This Cabal Lackey has been pretty clutch for us. It only brought out a secret once, but it's been like, it's been available on turn one, like half of our game. And that's made a big difference. I'm gonna Noiltron no matter what he plays. And then I'm gonna Nerubian Prophet after that, probably. Oh my god. Yes. Actually having a chance against a Warlock. Nomad Bomber, go away. We don't want your kind here. Not until he swings the board. Then we will need you. You are way too early.
Drink the power. What to do? What to do?
I'm hoping for a top deck. Top deck, top deck, top deck. Not a top deck.
Wanna blow something up?
Bottoms up. No longer playing against Hellfire. We lose if he Hellfires. Maybe I should have. But, like, I got him down to 13. Feels wrong to Hellfire. Okay. This is a thing. Turn I get Fen Creeper and Hero Power. He's shown he has no real removals, so I'm expecting to be able to get a lot more damage in. Maybe he has more big taunts, which would suck. Alright, medium sized taunt, I'll take it. I'm okay if he wants to Abyssal Enforcer. Much less okay with that. Much less okay with that. Okay. He's gonna run out at some point. Oh, what? Holy crap, why would you ever do that? I have things that deal 2 damage. No. Don't care. Don't care. It's face. Every turn I ping face. Because he plays 3 minions. Wait, what? That can't be right.
Total corruption! Total power! Total corruption! Total power!
Never mind. One way to do it. And that's lethal.
Well played. Drink the power.
It would have been hilarious if I had a dragon fire potion anyway, and I used that before I killed him. 5-2! We said 5 wins! We got 5 wins! And now this next game, whether we win or lose, will bring us into 11 o'clock, so the timing works out too. Oh! Who needs 12 wins when you can get 5? 12-2? No. Okay, if I take this to 12 wins, I'm expecting, like, just mass waves of cheers happening.
Gina versus
in the chat. Because this is not getting to, like, even 8. I think this will stop at 7. I can't see it ever getting above 7 wins. That flame imp was such a bad call. It's true, that flame imp was an awful call. The hit Voodoo Doctor play is as strong as a 2-drop. So, I decided to take advantage while I could. Also, that doesn't do anything.
Reporting for duty.
Because I just hero power.
Bottoms up.
Don't leave, Adwicto. There's no one online. Crip will be online soon.
Reporting for
yes,
duty.
Hit it. Oh, yes. Although this Voodoo Doctor is not all that great. Now that we're hitting things. Heal, hit, Medivh's valet.
Someone called for the doctor.
Bottoms up.
No!
I could ping. He kills the 2-2. I have a 2-1. If I'm Medivh's valet. I have a 2-3. The difference between the two on the board, whether I ping or Medivh's valet, is whether I have a 2-1 on the board or a 2-3. I thought the potential that the 2-3 was going to actually be more useful than a 2-1 was very, very low. Because he didn't even have a 2-drop. So you can't hero power to play a 2. He's definitely playing a 4 here. Yep. Which means what I gonna use that lay would have been totally pointless. If I throw it in, and then Mad Bomber, and then Medivh's valet. Blue Quark! 1 year! Thanks for subbing, man. Almost 1 century. Okay. Yeah, I think this is the best way. It just, it clears the whole board out. Oh, yes! Blue Quark says, got 12? Yes. Got 12, Blue Quark. That's where this deck is going. He has muster for battles. We have nothing, but it doesn't matter. That's how this deck is going. Alright, Rump Rabbit, I'm gonna hold you to it. If this goes 12, you will eat your socks. I can get so much more value out of this bomb squad later.
I wonder.
I can get more value out of the Nerubian Prophet later too, though. And this Medivh's valet.
Runs out on me.
He's gonna do this. We'll go for the tempo. With this deck, I always go for the tempo because I have plenty of value coming up. Good. Good. Do it. Perfect. I like all this. I 2-2-2. He kills one. He kills the other. I win if I Cabal Chemist, Bluegill his face, and his ogre
runs out on me.
Misses the Cabal Chemist.
Drink the power.
Also, this was a pretty good potion for the Medivh's valet. Okay. Do it. Ogre, hit my face or the 2-1 and use your weapon to hit the 3-3. No, Oh, good. Only buffs two things. So I'm definitely getting the card advantage. Yes!
No heal, no heal, no heal.
What doesn't brute kill? Okay, that's fine.
Reporting for duty.
Alright. We did it, guys. We did it. And next turn, we can Argent, Potion of Polymorph, and Medivh's Valet for 3 damage. Which also means we basically put him at lethal. If we go face. And he doesn't kill at least the 4-4. Even if he kills the 4-4, we would have lethal the turn after that if he doesn't heal. Oh, he just healed for... Whoa! What's a 10 mana? Hold on. Is that and everything can happen? Is it, wait, what is 10 mana? There's only one thing, right? It's everything can happen. He has no Murlocs yet. He just took it to heal. I'm struggling to figure out what actually just happened.
Excuse me, you are on fire.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
Giddy up!
Maybe the other cards were so crappy he just took the biggest heal? Yeah, maybe. And maybe he has, like, Murloc Knights in his hand, you know? Oh, this is pretty good for Blizzard. And I haven't been playing like I have a Flame Strike, because I don't. So hopefully he'll start Blizzarding. Give me small stuff. Oh, poor you. Poor you. I could Blizzard and go, but it's not actually very good.
Squire, attend me. Spartan.
Ready, sir.
He can't control the ogre, so I'm not really that afraid. He can't buff this so much that actually kills the 9-9 unless he gets lucky with the ogre. Consecration. Go for it. Okay, I care a little bit about that.
Reporting for duty.
Now he can kill one of my two big things. Punished? Yeah. I was kind of punished. He still can't kill, though. Oh, God. Now he can. Alright. Please play more things. Like, one of the things in his hand is a nothing, right? Like, it's not a thing.
You want it? I got it.
Arcane Blast is pretty good. So is Freezing Potion. I'll just Arcane Blast. Need to be greedy with the Freezing Potion. So he has a 10 mana card in his hand and he has a spare part. Yep. Good job. Well played. The victory
is yours. 6 wins!
Alright! Alright, look at this. 6 wins with this mage. This is good about the mage. The hero power works so much wonders. Your deck could be this bad, and you could still get to 6 wins. This deck is not going past 7, though. Like, there's cliffs in this game at this point. Like, we need some DCs if this is going to go past 7. So, I wouldn't think it's crazy if we win one more, but we can't win 2 more. And no one bet 7. You guys are on board. 3 people bet 6. No one bet 7. No one bet more than that. Victory. Except one person bet 12. Okay. So this is where we lose. Ugh. Tiger Rally says, if it goes past 7, you eat socks? Dude, I'm not eating socks, man. Stop it with the whole sock eating obsession. We're not even getting past this one. We're against a priest and we're not going to curve out on turn 3. Actually may not be that bad. Depending on what his follow-up is. Oh, come on! Freaking kooky chemist! Delicious. I can't play anything else, but that's so bad. That is so bad.
Blessed be this funnel cake!
Well, so far he's played like really bad cards, and he has no buffs. So far this is going amazingly. For us. I need damage. See my play, right? Ooh. I do this, it goes in. I could bomb squad throw this in and ping also. Or I could this go in and kooky chemist the 3/5, so it flips but it has nothing to really kill. And then I end up with a Zubat on the board. If I bomb squad, ping. Murloc surprise? What's the Murloc gonna do? Oh! Oh! That's actually really cool.
What to do? What to do?
I didn't even think about that. Okay, so they used up the Murloc. But preserves my kooky chemist. Christos! I don't know. I don't know if that was the right play. I think kooky chemist may have been actually, like, more stuff on the board. Because that ping was useless, right? Like, we got one extra tempo that was useful, but then we backed out 2 tempo. Because we couldn't use our mana efficiently. So I don't even think that was, like, a good play. Wait, what? Okay. Cool. Fight.
the powers.
Alright, he's getting his card advantage, but we're holding board. And that freezing potion wasn't really card advantage.
It only cost my soul.
Okay, I see what he's doing. Cookie chemist, trade. Saving the bomb squad. Or a bomb squad trade, yes. A bomb squad trade, and then I have a 4, which I will cabal.
Drink the power.
Blood Fury potion.
It's boom o'clock!
The cookie chemist can get more value. Like right here. Very good value on the cookie chemist. Cookie chemist. Like a blood fairy potion to get value. Or I could just tomb spider and play a Medivh's valet. And trade 2 things in. Yeah, I'll trade 2 things in. My ex, no.
Delicious spider ichor.
Drink up. No! Boom!
Excuse me, you are all.
I'm not waiting for this mirror entity. It's one card in my deck. I was waiting for that potion a little bit, but I'm not waiting for the mirror entity.
Drink the power.
He's just waiting until he gets it, whatever fire potion. Seriously? All right.
This only
it's gonna hurt you.
Simple-minded.
Oh no, it's not gonna hurt him. Okay. All right. This card advantage thing's coming back. I have a lot of big cards left. I have the board. Alright, whatever. I get this back. He killed my 2-drop and he dealt 3 damage to this for 1 mana. Fine, whatever. But I get this back. And it's gonna kill his 6-7. Don't have mind controls. Top deck your 2-drops. Let me draw my Ethereal Conjurers.
For the crusade!
Oh, that's good. Do not have a way to kill the 1/2. His cards are only top decks. Small.
This only works on the simple-minded.
I'll take it.
You wish to live forever.
Okay.
Big. I hope you like my invention.
Good.
You want it? I got it.
Out on me.
Form of spire.
Ah!
sir.
Did he really not heal the 3-3? Holy crap.
Behold the might of storm.
Holy crap, why would you not? This guy deserves to lose so hard.
If you're sure.
Wouldn't Spell Slayer be good here? Explain why you don't like the card. Dude, Spell Slayer would be awful here. Why would you want to give him RNG cards? You have the board, you have the cards. He's slowly losing, you're slowly winning. The last thing you want to do is add RNG into this. This is like an exact situation where a Spell Slayer is like barely playable. Alright, well, that didn't do a lot, but still stuff. I still have plenty of cards to bear this out.
Welcome to the exact.
Uh-oh. That could be big. But I have seized the board and I have no more two drops.
The damned stand ready.
Good. I lived through all of this. Victory is close. Guys, we may have just ground out a priest. We just ground out a priest. His holy grace on top of that. Whew. Okay, this is the wall I'm talking about. We are now 7-2. We're gonna lose the next game. You'll see the deck. It will not only be much better than this deck, it will be much better than this deck. So what we're hoping for now is a DC. That is the only way we can win, is a DC, or we curve out and he doesn't curve out at all. Like, he misses two curve turns. Like, no 2, no 3, or no 2, no 4, or no 3, no 4. Even if he misses one curve play, we're probably not going to win. And for people who doubt why Mage is good, this is why Mage is good. This exact thing right here, where you end up getting a crappy deck, which happens, you know, not infrequently now with Mage, but if you're good at the game, you can still bring it to, like, a certain goodness just from using the hero power repeatedly.
Jaina versus Jaina.
You asked for it.
Like, you guys bet 3 on the deck when we were 0-1, but I was still saying we could get 5. This is obviously overperforming. And that's something you can't do with any other deck. Like, that's just a pure Mage thing, because the hero power is so bonkers.
You want to cast a spell? I want to cast a spell.
Okay, that doesn't count as a curve card. So, we're still okay there.
Don't forget to tip your Torrin.
I'm not bombering that. Good.
The end.
Gives him a smaller target. And if he's gonna ping anyway, we can do other stuff. So far he's like half curved out.
Hmm.
And we're gonna like half curve out.
You wanna cast a spell? I wanna cast a spell.
Okay. I see what he's doing. Cabal, Lackey, Annoyotron, Go Face. I really wish this was a voodoo doctor. That'd be game winning.
Hmm.
Bomber love.
Bottoms up.
Wanna blow something up?
Whatever. I'll take it. It was one of the ways in which we could win the game. And I think we were at the point in which we needed things to win the game. So, he's up one card right now on us, and he's gonna be up two. Don't do it. Do not have Twilight Flamecaller.
Can I light your fire?
Do not top deck Twilight Flamecaller! You've gotta be kidding me.
Squire, attend me!
Ready, sir. You just top deck Twilight Flamecaller.
Delicious spider, nigga!
Okay, fine. Don't care. Good, he doesn't do anything about it. All right, how do we want to do this? 5, 3, 4. We can sack these two, hit it in. That's pretty good. We can flip it, which is always good. And then make the trade, and then we have a 3-6 and a 4-4. Yeah, let's save the Stormwind.
I wonder.
Delicious spider, Ica.
If you insist.
This keeps the Stormwind on for one more turn, so I need to use the Stormwind well this next turn. If I had used the Stormwind, I need to use the Kooky Chemist well the turn after that. The good part is, if the Stormwind survives, Kooky Chemist gives +1/+1 to something on the board, even if it's just normal stats. But the bad part is, if the Stormwind doesn't, who knows when Kooky Chemist could get that kind of value again. Whereas Stormwind is very likely to get good value here. Oh, well, okay.
Behold the might of Storm!
Have another dose!
I'm set up. What's he got? He's been setting this up this whole game. He's been pinging, he's been slow, he has board clears. Yeah, like he definitely has board clears. Whether he has enough, different story, right? There's no way he doesn't have board clears. I haven't given him a good flame strike turn yet. He flame strikes. He has 5 cards. I have 3 cards.
What to do?
He's at 14. I'm not gonna win.
Get him, boys.
If he flame strikes, he has a 2-card card advantage on me that I'm not gonna get back. He probably has a flame strike because he's been holding cards forever. But I lose if he has a flame strike. Like, it doesn't matter what I hold back. I lose on tempo if I don't play, like, at least half my cards.
Engaging TC,
and then he... Okay, so he doesn't have Flame Strike. That's good. I don't really care about the Mind Control. I'm all about face now. I have high health. He's gonna have low health.
I wonder.
Let's see how many taunts he has. That's not a taunt. It's dangerous, but it's not a taunt. Got a Voodoo Doctor. 6... Plus 5, that's 11. That's fine.
Someone called for the die.
but that's fine.
Time runs out of
He has no board clear. He can only ping one thing, and then he removes two things on the board. And I'm close. Because I have no reach in this entire deck. And he has no, like, he has no taunts, he has no board clears. He has a Cabalist Tome now, which kind of sucks, but...
Don't mess with
Tusk. Good, he got nothing, and his spells. Alright. This is it. He's dead next turn. I have Archer Horsar, yeah, but eventually he's gonna get a taunt, you know? Like, if I went phase, he does something crazy, I ping, he heals, I'm done. I could get more damage over, like, three turns this way than the other way. And it wasn't like I set up lethal. If I did it, if I had one more damage on him, and I could have gotten lethal the next turn, I would have just gone phase. But being at two, giving him two turns to set up, with a potential eight damage surviving, that gives him potential lethal.
You win.
GG. We are 8-1. Don't know how that happened. He did ping a lot, right? Like, he didn't curve out very well, so... I said you had to not curve out on two turns. He, like, half curved out on, like, three turns. And that ended up being enough. And our kooky chemist, like, blew a lot of his expectations away.
Jaina versus Jaina!
Crap.
You asked for it.
What I really want to face are, like, not mages. Because all I have is quality, like, in terms of the late game. And when you face mages, they have it too, so... It's kind of pointless.
What to do? What to do?
We have reactive cards. Let's play this reactively.
Don't forget to tip your Torrent.
There's no need to tempo out here. We have plenty of big taunts. The mage isn't going to be tempoing out. Our face should be safe. He can't ping this turn, so he has to play a 3-drop. And that gives us a lot of things we can do. Everything from Kooky Chemist... to coining out to twos, play a mirror. So he wants to copy something. Probably a mad bomber.
What to do?
But I can't play a mad bomber. Maybe I just don't give him anything until I hit into it.
I wonder.
Yeah, okay. I'll give him the Archer Horse Rider.
Don't worry, Lux. The cavalry's here.
Bottoms up.
Okay.
Fire!
On the bright side, he has a potion of polymorph. You trade him first in case he has two of the same secret? He wouldn't have done it if he had two of the same secret. Okay, that's not it. He counters the coin. Perfect.
Don't forget to tip your Doran.
We're burning through his card advantage. Play like a 2/7. Kind of works and it kind of doesn't work. I flip it, I trade.
What to do?
No, this is no, I need to mirror entity.
Time runs out on me.
I need to mirror entity. I can't give him
this
board yet.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here. Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
It's a good enough card. Pretty bad.
Delicious spider dick.
For the spider.
He has 6 cards, I have 5 cards. I have the board. Should be okay.
I serve the fire lord.
About to not be okay?
I'm late.
Miss. Miss. Well, could have been worse.
Have another dose.
Do I Boulder Fist or do I Arcane Blossom? I guess I Boulder Fist. I don't really have anything I'm protecting against. He pings the 2/1. His 5/5 needs to either trade up or eats the 4/3, and then I ping. Alright, fine. Interesting. I'm just playing into the flame strike. He doesn't seem like he has it. If he does, it's gonna ruin me. Like, he's gonna be up 2 cards if he has a flame strike, but he doesn't. Does he have a Firelance? He doesn't have a Firelance. Wow, he's holding on to that Firelance for a while. That's cool. He makes the trades for us. Oh, Mukla's is gonna be good. Good ping, we can hit. Yes. It's gonna be Mukla's. Unfortunately, we can't do it this turn.
Me smash.
Oh.
are on. Okay. His final card is a...
Excuse me.
Okay.
You are on fire.
I have the advantage here.
Delicious spider ichor.
This card is too scary to leave.
Right away.
I'm gonna force him to do it. I'm gonna start getting some face damage. I'm up a card on him. And if he chooses to go face, I have more stuff with Mukhlis to buff. There's no point in me trading. That was good. Now I save it. So he just wasted a Frostbolt. It's perfect. Oh, yes. We earned one more card on him. Now we're up two cards on him. Old school mage strategies.
Shall we put
when all you got? That's a classic. Okay. Pinging doesn't really do much. Stormwind's what I want. Actually, no, Bomb Squad's what I want. Adds one more thing to Stormwind. Storm trade seems fine. I want damage on his face. This way I get damage on his face and I win the next turn.
Well played.
I don't know why my computer's slowing down so much. Like, you guys see it, right? Like, it's like lagging for some reason. Hopefully this makes it better. Okay. What are we now? We're 9-2 now. Holy crap. We're 9-2 with this deck. So we keep going. Man, I thought I was gonna be like done with this and play Overwatch by like 11 with this deck, but we keep going. We're not stopping tonight until this is over.
Jaina versus
Highest Horse says, what do you think this game needs more? Cards with heal or cards with feature babes like Secret Keeper? I will say there are fewer beautiful women on cards of Hearthstone than I would think for a game like this. But I have no idea what healing has to do with that. Keep the Annoyltron, toss the rest. I hope this gets to 12 so he has to put it on YouTube. I hope it gets to 12 too. I would love... I may put this on YouTube even if it doesn't get to 12. This has been so ridiculous. And just all like on the board play. Nothing else. There's nothing fancy going on here.
Don't forget to tip the door.
Haunted Creeper. Bump a 1-2 in. I don't know, he's gonna trade. I'm not gonna be able to get the second rate bruiser out. There's no good way to do it where I would get the second rate bruiser out the next turn. Like, maybe if I just hit in and did nothing, and he would trade the 2-1 in rather than the 1-1s. This was so good, though. We're gonna be up a card. Even better if he plays something with 2 health this turn.
It's clobbering.
Yeah, okay, not that.
Time.
3. Top deck 3. Okay, this works too. So.
Bottoms up.
Someone called for the down.
I'm hoping I get a card the next turn. If I didn't think I was going to get a card the next turn, I would have pinged the 4-4 while playing the Voodoo Doctor.
Because then no matter which he kills, I will ping and then bluegill.
Not on my watch.
Alright, that really doesn't do all that much. Yes! We can second rate Bruiser. Good. We didn't top deck anything good either.
I wonder.
I'm not ready.
I leave his 4/4 up because it may not kill my 4/5. And he doesn't want to buff it. If he has a buff, he wants to buff the 1/1 anyway.
Reporting for duty.
Yep. Nah, his ogre listens to him. It's not fun for us. I've drawn a lot of my big cards though, so we'll see how his deck shapes up. This could be so good. I'm not doing it though. I'm not listening to the bomber. He could have a buff. And if he does, I'll be screwed. I don't have a read that he doesn't have a buff, but those are literally the last three cards that he, like, picked up, so odds are pretty low. Cool.
Reporting for duty.
Cool, cool. So, unfortunately, I can't Boulder Fist Ogre. So, we're playing for card advantage here. Let's play for card advantage.
You wanna blow something up?
This has the same card advantage, if not the best tempo. The alternative was to just Stranglethorn Tiger, but then I still have no way to get rid of this Cobra. Pillslingin', welcome to the Grinning Goat! Got goat, thanks for subbing, man.
Follow the rules.
That's fine. Here. Gained like a half card's worth of card advantage. Yes, I know I have Argent Horse Rider, but I don't, like, if he does a taunt or something, I do not want that thing behind a taunt. I will take this loss. By the way, I really don't know what's happening with my computer. So once again, we're even on cards. I have a very slight, like, we just shift the board back and forth. This is, like, a really intense game. Which is why every card advantage point kind of counts. Okay, good. So now I'm up a card, but he's got something big going on. Which is cool. Bring that down to 3. Bring that down to 5. Doesn't help me, though.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
Alright, let's see what he's got. Oh, crap.
Reporting for duty. Get in there and fight!
This guy in the freaking top decks. I can't take another damage to the face, so... I care if he... I have nothing better to do for him anyway. I'll trade. We're still trading on the board, but now he has the board by a little bit rather than me having the board by a little bit.
Heels up. Red alert. Heels up. Red alert.
This is where our hero power can earn us a card.
Behold the might of Storm.
Or not. Or yes.
might of Stormwind!
Weapons ready.
He has to decide to kill the 3-3 and preserve the board, or to go face and go for the reach. Yeah, he's playing the board. Tells me he has a large deck, and we need to start drawing our big cards ASAP.
For the Alliance!
I'm okay taking another hit. I still have 8, even if I take another hit. And if he has a sword and he's not putting it on the board, it's okay. Like, he kept the card, I didn't play it the last turn. But I don't really care what it is. Like, give me another consecration, doesn't matter. Mm. Like, what would he not have used on my 6-6? What do you think his card is? The card that, what card would you pick as the paladin and not play in a top deck situation where there's a 6-6 on the board?
What?
They oh, fell okay, the that makes sense. So he's on it. He knows his outs. He's basically admitted defeat already. This is dangerous, but I have to do it.
It's boom o'clock.
Reporting for duty.
Again, what would you keep in this situation?
The victory is yours.
10-2. All right. This mage deck, man. Adwicto, why not Blast Crystal the Bomb Squad? Yes. That is a move. I could destroy my own minion and deal 5 damage to my face. These are things that could happen. So this is what a 10-2 mage looks like. Because it's mage. Like, people keep saying things, you know, but it's mage. At the end of the day, it's still mage. It can still do this stuff. All mage decks can do this stuff. It's not easy, but it's possible. Whereas warlocks can't. Like, a bad warlock deck just can't do this. That's why, like, if you're a good player, you prefer, like, classes like mage, classes like druid, classes like rogue. Because even when the things go bad, you can bring them to, like, 5 wins, 7 wins. I see no world in which I play Bluegill over a Mad Bomber. By the way, something's seriously wrong with my computer. It's like all slowing down. It's Chrome.
Do you need a blessing?
Wanna blow something up?
Perfect. That is the perfect things to hit.
It's time for a little okay. blood.
This is fine.
Hoo-hoo, yeah, you got it!
Excuse me, you are on fire.
I wish I had a 3-mana card. And I wish I had a 4-mana card. Oh, he does nothing. Oh no, he does something. Okay, this is where I'm screwed. Chemist or a spider? Probably a chemist.
Drink the power.
Actually pretty good.
Right away.
Like, that actually works perfectly.
Stop yelling!
Get in there and fight, maggot!
Okay. This works better.
Get them, boys.
Ceiling triple.
Right away.
I will ping and Tomb Spider next.
I was right all along.
Okay. That's a problem.
Delicious spider.
Don't forget to tip the gun
right away.
Four mana, 4/4, destroy a 5-drop. Let's storm one out this. Give me something to eat. Feed me.
Total corruption. Total power.
That's not good. Oh, why do you not do things?
Time runs out on me.
I don't know if that was the right play. Maybe I should have pinged the 3-1. Given him 2-1-1s, let him make all the trades, but I'm being forced to slow down right now. So. He's gonna abyssal. He's gonna abyssal. Yeah, he has to trade into the 4-1. Okay. Rocket science. You cannot go to my face. I am a mage. You have 12 health.
For Blackwing.
Unfortunately, do not have a choice. I need this blizzard pretty badly. Like, he's scared because he has like lowish health and I'm a mage, but I don't have any reach. Oh, he's not scared anymore.
Trust me.
Now I really, really need this blizzard. I'm dead the next turn if I don't get this blizzard. I think I'm just dead if I don't get this blizzard. Okay, Ancient of Blossoms
means I live. And he has to trade. Like, if he doesn't have removal, then he has to put 6-6 into the 3-8, 2-2 into the 3-8 to heal both of us.
I wonder.
And yeah, he needs at least one damage or else he can't kill the 8-6. And it's very dangerous if he doesn't kill the 8-6, because I'm 3 damage away from lethal on the board. And I'm actually only 2 damage away with the Stormwind champion. So if I get like a Argent Horse Rider or a Bluegill. Oh no, he heals. He's fine. He's fine. Oh, come on. How many freaking blasters the Poges do you have?
What doesn't blue kill?
Alright, now we lose. And we got the Argent Horse Rider too! Oh my god. That would have been the best lethal.
Behold the might of the cavalry.
I mean, it's still something. Alright, this deck is gonna end at 10-2. And I'm okay with that. It is, and has always been, a pretty bad deck. Do it.
You're in trouble now.
I needed him to have all small cards. I figured that's my only out.
I'm not red card.
And this freaking blizzard, or like an ethereal conjurer into something good. It's just not happening. He doesn't even have the hero power again. We're down way too many cards. We're not gonna be able to make it back. He has to have all small cards. We have the blizzard. It's always been the same thing.
You want it?
Not fast enough.
Got it.
Was a ray of hope. That was a ray of hope. If it hit our face, we would have had one extra minion on the board.
You will regret this.
Maybe I should have pinged the 3-5. Because then he double hits. Why is this guy still tapping? He's now in pyroblast range. He knows that, right? He just unnecessarily put himself in pyroblast range. Oh, because he's about to win the game. Right, or rather, because he was going to be in pyroblast range anyway. But now he's in freaking fireball range. Holy crap.
The truth is in here.
Can I please get a blizzard?
I hope you like my invention.
Nope.
Well played.
Bomb Squad's one off. Like, I need to blizzard so it freezes everything. And ping his face once. And then I have all my stuff here. And then I need to, like, bomb squad his guy. And then get enough into his face. It was never reasonable. Okay, this deck went 10. This was not a reasonable 10-win deck. No one gets grass.
Nobody gets grass because no one voted for 10 wins. Rella Frog says it was still a very good run, Adokta. I'm proud of you. Thanks, man. I'm proud of myself. This was a good run. And whenever Merb says how Mage is not good, point him to this run. This is like proof of just how good Mage is. Like, if you're good at the very fundamentals of evaluating, like, how what your win conditions are and your board and whatever, it's just the worst Mage deck is still playable to, you know, 10 wins. Because this is really one of the worst decks that I have ever seen for a Mage.